The specification pattern can grow quickly and wildly, complicating your code for no benefit. In this demo, I will show you how even a simple specification can bring great power to your application. The demo is about a situation you will commonly encounter. A program communicates with an external RESTful API. I'm integrating with a GitHub API to query repositories. This class is my client to the GitHub RESTful API. Here is the method that returns an asynchronous sequence of some repo objects. That was the integration with GitHub API. This command uses the GitHub API client to collect and display the repositories. Let me show you what this application displays. I am looking for 15 repositories written in the C# programming language, each with more than 10 stars, sorted descending by the number of stars. That is precisely what I can see in this table. I consider this a success, but my appetites grow. I need a more advanced integration for the next stage of my project. That will affect the URL we use to query the GitHub API. There is the base URL, followed by the filter, sort order specification, and pagination. Pagination is encapsulated in this client class. The caller doesn't even know anything about it. But this part is of great interest to the caller: filtering and sorting the repos. I could parameterize the method to receive the programming language or the number of stars. These parameters would become a part of the query. Make sure to escape the string to prevent injection. But things quickly get worse. I am carefully constructing the query parameter to support omitting any or both parameters. Then we support the configurable sort order. The sort order could also be optional. My code is growing, though I'm still able to satisfy the requirements. Let me show you how this works. For example, the caller might clear the language filter. This will just work. However, more requirements are coming, and this approach with parameterizing the method will not be enough. This is how you ask for repositories containing the word Maui in the name or description. How could I manage this with a method parameter? Method parameters are a powerful way of configuring behavior, but only in simple cases. Well, my application is no longer simple. I need a bigger hammer. I will introduce a class that represents the query for repositories. It should be able to tell all the filters and sort orders the API supports. That will be a special form of the specification design pattern. You probably know the specification from an interface such as this one. A specification would check the object and return yes or no. That is what it does. A good specification should be composable. It is common to include operators such as AND and OR that combine two specifications into a new one. The NOT operator would invert the decision of a specification. Still, you may have noticed that this interface doesn't really fit the needs of my demo. The general specification checks the objects, but we need it to query the API. There are no objects to check yet. That leads us to a special kind of specification, often called a query specification. It doesn't have this isSatisfiedBy member at all. Its sole purpose is to tell some other class which objects to retrieve. The AND, OR, and NOT operators remain. The most important difference is in how we execute the specification. Remember the implementation of iQueryable in EF Core. That is a query specification. You would use the operators on iQueryable to create a large iQueryable object. EF Core would then translate that into a SQL statement. iQueryable also reminds us that something is missing in this interface. Query specification usually consists of two subspecifications. One tells how to filter the objects, and another tells how to sort them. The query specification would combine filter specifications to construct a complex query, and it would apply sorting, either ascending or descending. This makes for a powerful query specification. Now you choose the level of complexity that suits your application. Remember EF Core and iQueryable again. It would probably take you a month of coding just to come up with the simplest possible implementation that works. On the other hand, ask yourself whether you need that level of complexity. I would advise to start small. For example, quite often you won't need the OR and NOT operators. You can then give the AND operator a more descriptive name, such as WHERE. Chaining multiple WHERE operators behaves like using AND. Then we consider the usefulness of having an interface. Will I ever integrate with another repository's API similar to the GitHub API? That might not be realistic in this project. There will never be a second implementation of this interface. I don't think I will inject the query either. If that is so, don't create the interface. It would only torture you and stand in the way. Just tailor a specification to one RESTful API and do nothing more. Let filtering and sorting work in terms of this single API. Don't make it worse. Start small and take the most out of it. I will now provide the implementation. Please note that you can download the entire source code before and after this change from my Patreon page. This channel is free thanks to patrons. Every registered patron is helping hundreds of other fellow programmers watch all the videos on my channel for free. Now to the implementation. I will start with sorting just to show you what I plan on a simple example. The query specification will let its caller know if there is a sort order. If so, it would tell the sort clause. Both properties are internal because these details belong to the GitHub API. The code that creates the query doesn't need to know these details. This idea will make implementing the repo sort specification trivial. It won't even need to be abstract. It will expose the field by which to sort, but it won't let the caller set the field freely. There are only four values you can legally send to GitHub API as repo sort keys. I will support three out of those with static factory methods. You can always skip the parts of the API your application doesn't need. The sort specification is done. The full query specification will keep the sort criterion which might be missing. The Boolean property will tell whether there is a sort order. The sort clause would format the key value pair for the query string if there is a sort order. We also need an order clause, which I forgot to include. It is another key value pair indicating ascending or descending order. This shows that you can write powerful query specifications with very little code. Let's get to the filter specification. A string will contain the encoded filter. You cannot set this string because it will observe the rules of URL encoding and the GitHub API. There will be a static factory method for every legal filter. Filtering by language, for example, will be the keyword the language followed by a colon and the encoded string. Another filter would request the minimum number of stars. There will be filters by a part of the name or the description. There are dozens of other possibilities supported by GitHub API, which my application doesn't support yet. Adding support for a different filter would boil down to adding one more static method to this class. There is still nothing in my project that would justify any implementation more complex than this. That brings us to the query specification. It will contain an array of repo filters. We only support AND, so the repo must satisfy all these filters. The specification will tell its caller whether it contains any query. It returns true when there are filters in the array. The entire query clause would either be empty or a key value pair with all the individual filters separated by pluses in its value. That is how GitHub API has defined the AND filter, and now my class is implementing that. I will now implement the methods that combine specifications. Please note that this specification is immutable. Consider implementing an immutable specification by default. The WHERE operator would add one more filter. It will return a new instance with all the old filters plus the new one appended at the end of the array and the sorting specification retained. Sort by and sort by descending will do a similar thing. They will retain the filters but overwrite the sort order. The last sorting specification will win. My work here is done. I promised you a simple query specification, and here it is. Using it will be even simpler. The GitHub API client will only accept one input parameter, the query. That will satisfy all future features. I will delete all the code that used to build the query. Simply include the optional Q parameter in the query string. The same goes with the sort order. Not only is my code doing more than it used to do before, but it is also significantly shorter. Let's see the effect on the ultimate consumer. You can prepare whatever query you like before fetching the data. Start from a new repo query and then add the clauses, like filtering by the C# language and by more than 10 stars, sorted descending by stars. That is one query. A different query would start from a new repo query object. It might request there is a MAUI in the description, sorted descending by the number of forks. No matter how you obtain the query object, you can pass it to the API client, which will return the repositories as you asked. Let me quickly run the application and you will see what it does. This is the result of the first query. C# repos with more than 10 stars, sorted descending by stars. The second query lists all kinds of repositories that mention MAUI, sorted descending by the number of forks. Beautiful. And the greatest beauty of this implementation is the query specification itself. It is no more than 50 lines of effective code, yet it fully satisfies all the various querying capabilities I had to support in my application. Now tell me in the comment, did it ever happen to you to implement a dozen types, all with interfaces, concrete classes, factories, injection and everything, without realizing that you will never utilize the full power of such an elaborate solution? Does that remind you of the story of the query specification pattern I implemented here?